فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We were speaking, or we're still in the sharh of the kitab, التحفة السنية في شرح مقدمة الأجرومية. We spoke about al-i'rab and what it means. And we also spoke about that i'rab deals with taghir, changing. And it means to changing of what? تغيير أواخر الكلمة. And we said what is meant by أواخر الكلمة, because some people may think it means that the last word or the last letter is going to change, and that's not the case. It's تغيير أحوال أواخر الكلمة. That's what's meant by it. We spoke about that as well. We also spoke about the changings that occur are two types. We said لفظي, and we also said, we said معنوي تقديري. So the first one is a changing which is لفظي. And we define what it means, the changing which is what? The changing which is لفظي. It is أن يكون مسموعا في الملفوظ. That you can hear it in pronunciation. ومريئا في المكتوب. And when you write it, you can see the changes. And we said تقديري is the opposite to that. Is ألا يكون مسموعا, that it is not heard in pronunciation, ولا مريئا, and it is not also seen في المكتوب in the writing. We're now going to finish off the sharh of Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, what he said رحمه الله رحمة واسعة. He says, and I wrote it on the board as well. He says, وعلم know أن هذا التغير, know that these changing, ينقسم, it is divided into إلى قسمين. Know that the changing that occurs in grammar is categorized into two. First one is لفظي, a changing which is lafzi. وتقديري, and a changing which is تقديري. Lafzi is explicit, and تقديري is what? Implicit. لذلك محمد محيدين عبد الحميد, look what he says, فأما اللفظي, as for the changing which is what? Explicit. فهو, it is ما لا يمنع من النطق. Nothing is preventing you from pronouncing it. بِهِ مَانِعٌ. There's no obstacle in front of you that's preventing you from pronouncing it. Are you there, brothers and sisters? كَمَا رَأَيْتَهَا, as you have seen, فِي حَرَكَةِ الدَّالِ مِنْ مُحَمَّدٍ, as you can see the last letter of the word Muhammad. Muhammad, look. جَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ رَأَيْتُ مُحَمَّدًا مررت بمحمد. All of those you can hear the changing. Nothing stopping us from, look at it, the dal, mashallah, محمدًا, محمدٌ, محمدٍ, no problem. The same is the word يسافر. Are you with me? The word يسافر, يسافر. Are you with me? The word changes, right? It goes through changes based on whatever goes before it. For example, you would say, لَنْ يُسَافِرَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. لَنْ يُسَافِرَ. Okay. You would say, for instance, يُسَافِرُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. يُسَافِرُ. Okay, change it. لَمْ يُسَافِرْ إِبْرَاهِيمُ. It changed. So it changed from يُسَافِرُ to يُسَافِرَ to yusafir. So there it is. The changing is something you can hear. Nothing stopping you from it. Very good. وَأَمَّا تَقْدِيرِيُّ. As for the one that's taqdeer, which is the second one, he said it's an implicit one. فَهُوَ. It is. مَا يَمْنَعُ مِنَ التَّلَفُّظِ بِهِ مَانِعٌ. It is when you're prevented from pronouncing it. And there are three things that prevent you from it. The first one is ta'adhurin, and we spoke about what ta'adhur is. We spoke about what ta'adhur is. Who is ta'adhur referring to? The alif. Very good. And then aw istithqalin. Istithqal means when it's heavy. It can be done, but it's heavy. And that's referring to which one? Al-waw and al-ya. Very good. أو مناسبة. The مناسبة is what? It's the ya that enters the ism only. At the ending of the ism. It doesn't enter fi'il. This is khas. It's specific to what? Al-asma'i, nouns. Okay? And the author, rahimahullah, the sharih, sorry, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he gave an example on the board. So inshallah ta'ala, we'll look at the example. If you can just look at the example on the board. Okay, what does he say? Rahimahullah, he says, يَدْعُ الْفَتَى. He says, يَدْعُ الْفَتَى وَالْقَاضِي وَغُلَامِي. All of these words, you can't really hear the changes that have happened to it. The word يَدْعُ is فِعْل مُضَارِع, which is مَرْفُوع لِتَجَرُّدِهِ مِنَ النَّاصِبِ وَالْجَازِمِ. What does it mean, لِتَجَرُّدِهِ مِنَ النَّاصِبِ وَالْجَازِمِ? يَدْعُو, there's no أَدَوَاتُ الْجَزْمِ and أَدَوَاتُ النَّصْبِ, which we're going to take, inshallah ta'ala. They haven't gone through it. I mean, they haven't entered it. Or they're not before it. And the فِعْل مُضَارِع, if أَدَوَاتُ الْجَزْمِ and أَدَوَاتُ النَّصْبِ doesn't enter it, is مَرْفُوع. You leave it مَرْفُوع. We'll speak about that in details. But there it is, you can't hear it. You can't hear علامات الرفع on it, whether it be the those which are أصل and or those which are the نوائب, أما النائبة. And then you have يدعو الفتى. الفتى here is what? Is مرفوع لكونه فاعلا. It is مرفوع because it's the subject. It's the one that's doing the calling. قاضي and غلامي, both of them are مرفوعان. They're both also مرفوع. قاضي الغلامي, both of them are مرفوع. But why are they both مرفوع? لأنهما معطوفان. They have حروف العطف before it and they are being connected to who? الفتاة. Here it is. Not one of them is the ضمّة apparent on the last letting of the wording. Not one of them. Huh. Yeah? Tajarrud is when you strip something from something. The word tajarrud means what? It's to strip something from a thing. So you strip something from something. The yad'u is stripped from adawat al-jazmi or adawat al-nasmi. Why is the word al-fata? Al-fata. Let's look at it. Why does it not show the adawat al-jazmi? Why does it, the raf'i does not show on it? What does Al-Fatah finish with? Alif. If Alif finishes with it, what is it? Ta'adhur, right? No. Halatul Dhamma, and when it's Fatha, what is with the Alif? What, those two times is Muqaddar. Okay. Na'am. We're going to speak about it. So we've got Al-Fata. And what about Yad'u? Yad'u is what? Yad'u is Munasaba. Yeah? Istithqal. I said Munasaba is khasul lil asma'. Yad'u is istithqal, it's heavy. Very good. It's heavy on it. وَفِي الْقَاضِي قَاضِي, it doesn't show. For what reason? Yeah? Al-Qadi. Istithqal, eh? It's an ism. نعم, وَفِي الْقَاضِي, the Qadi is also istithqal. The Qadi is also istithqal. Just to see if you were saying it, you're just saying it. Ghulami is what? Ghulami is istithqal. The ya in ghulami, my. It is. Very good. So we have those three reasons. At-ta'addur, istithqal, and what? Al-munasabah. All present. Al-fata, and al-qadhi, ghulami, and also yad'u. Yad'u is istithqal. Qadhi is istithqal. Fata is ta'addur. Ghulami is munasaba. And we spoke about this last lesson. None of it does it show. Very good. And the author gives another example, which is لَنْ يَرْضَ الْفَتَى وَالْقَاضِي وَغُلَامِي. None of them also show. So this is when it doesn't show. And we said it doesn't show when it's what? When it finishes with any of those three wordings, waw, alif, and ya. We said the fatha and the dhamma and the sukoon. Are you there? Sorry, if it's alif, it's ta'addur. If it's ya and waw, it is what? Istithqal. And if it's ya, like ulami, is munasaba, and it's only specific to asma. Very good. If the last ending of the verb, a verb, if the last ending of a verb is an alif, it is muqaddar fi halatayn, it is muqaddar two times. The first time is al-dhamma and the second time is fatha. If it's a verb and it finishes with a waw or a ya, it is muqaddar only one time, and that is when it's dhamma. As for the ism, if the last letter of it is an alif, تُقَدَّرُ فِي حَالَاتِهِ, all of its forms you do muqaddar, all the three times, whether it be fatha, dhamma, or kasra, it doesn't matter. And if the last letter is a ya, تُقَدَّرُ فِي حَالَتَيْنِ, if it's ya, it's muqaddar فِي حَالَتَيْنِ, two times, al-dhammatu and al-kasra. As for waw, did we say it finishes with a noun? No. The waw doesn't enter a noun. Very good. If you remember those, inshallah ta'ala. Now the author, the Sharih, rahimahullah, he moves away from i'rab. We've now understood what i'rab means. We've learned what i'rab means. Now the author, the Sharih, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he goes towards al-bina'u. What does he go to? Al-bina'u. Bina is what? Bina is the opposite of i'rab. The bina is the opposite of i'rab. So it will become clear to us what it means, inshallah ta'ala. So let's first of all define what bina means lughatan. Let's define it lughawiyan. Linguistically, let's define it. Bina lughatan, what does it mean? Ibaratun an wad'in shay'in ala shay'in ala jihatin yuradu biha thubut wal luzum. Is when you place something on top of another thing, and what you intend from it is that these two things, they stay together, they don't leave each other. It's like basically when you do building. You take one brick, and you put that brick on another brick. Muhammadin Abdul Hamid brings it. Well, our copies are different. My copy is 24. Is ibaratun an wad'i shay'in ala shay'in ala shay'in ala jihatin yuradu biha thubutu wal luzumu. It is wad'u shay'in, is to place something, shay'in ala shay'in, on top of something else, ala jihatin, in a way يُرَادُ بِهَا الثُّبُوتُ You intend from it to be firm, hard, like stuck together, don't leave each other, okay? It's when you take a cement and you took a brick and you put it on top of another brick. This is called bina. It's called bina. That's what it means linguistically. But the word bina, technically, it means لُزُومُ أَوَاخِرِ الْكَلِمَةِ So what meaning does it take from the lugha meaning? The word لُزُوم. The intent why you took that brick and you put it on top of that brick. What was the intent behind it? So they stay together. They don't leave each other. That this is permanent for now, okay? It's permanent, sorry. Okay? That's what you intend. That this is a permanent thing. Okay? That's what you intend. Good, pay attention. When grammarians, they use the word bina, this is what they're trying to say, that this word is, this is its permanent state. This is how it's always been. So it's luzumu awakhir al-kalimi. Kalimati, sorry. The last ending of the wording is remaining. It is permanent. It's consistent. Halatan wahida. It's consistent upon one situation. لِغَيْرِ عَامِنٍ وَلَا اعْتِلَالٍ And the reason why it's like this is not because there's an agent or because there's a defect in the wording. No. If it's a defect, what does it become? مُقَدَّر. We go back to I'rab again. The reason why this word, so you might ask yourself, but we've just seen something like that. We had the word fatah. Al-fatah. Al-fatah is consistent. But the reason for al-fatah is i'lan. It's illah. It's an illah reason. And na'am, al-fatah does change. It's not hala wahida. It's just, it doesn't show. This one, on the other hand, doesn't change. Does not change. It's not changing. Okay? It doesn't change. Like, for example, the word kam. Kam is always kam. Whatever context you put it in, never will it change. Kam. And it's a mim at the ending of the word. And there's no illa there. Good. Mim, again. Kam and min are, they are luzum, they are consistent upon sukun. Your goal is going to see them. Like the word ha'ula'i, hadami, amsi, they are all consistent upon what? Kasri. They're all consistent upon the kasra. Wa luzumu mundu, the word mundu, and the word haythu, and others, they are consistent upon dam. The word ayna, Kayfa, they consist upon fatha. You'll never find them in any other way. Aina is aina, everywhere you find it. Kayfa, kayfa. Good. Are you there? We will take that in more details when we come to the sharh of Qatr al-Nada wa Ballu al-Sada. Ibn Hisham al-Ansari. More explanation will be done with the issue of Bina and if these are agreed upon and what the madahibs of the Nuhad, the grammarians, all believe regarding it. Then he says something very powerful now. Just from what he just mentioned to us, from the four sets of examples that he gave us, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid, he says, وَمِنْ هَذَا الْإِضَاحِ From that clarification, وَمِنْ هَذَا الْإِضَاحِ From that clarification, تَعْلَمُ You will come to know, أَنَّ أَلْقَابَ الْبِنَاءِ أَرْبَعَةٌ From what was just mentioned right now, you're going to learn that the alqab, he doesn't use the alamat. Because alama means when something changes. Okay, he's saying the nicknames for bina is four: السكون الكسر والضم والفتح. Those four are what? Some call it القاب. Some even call it أنواع. Its types. علاماته. No one would call it if you studied grammar properly. You should use القاب. But even what's better is to use anwa'u, its types. Types is better. So if somebody asks you, what are the types of bina? You say the types of bina are four. As-sukunu, sukun. Some words are consistent upon sukun. That's all they are upon. Like what we just took with the word kam and min. The second one is kasru. They are consistent upon, they're upon kasra. Ha'ula'i, hadami, amsi. Good. Dammu. They're just consistent upon what? Consistent upon dhamm. Like mundu, haythu. They consist upon dhamm. Good. Wal fathu. They're consistent upon fatha. Okay, they're consistent upon fatha. Such as ayna and kayfa. After clarifying everything for you, Muhammad Muhyiddin Abdul Hamid says, وَبَعْدَ بَيَانِ كُلِّ هَذِهِ الْأَشْيَاءِ لَا تَعْصُرُ عَلَيْكَ مَعْرِفَةُ الْمُعْرَبِ وَالْمَبْنِي. He said, after all of that clarification, it will not be hard on you knowing the difference between the mu'rab and the mabni. فَإِنَّ الْمُعْرَبَ, because mu'rab is what? What's mu'rab? مَا تَغَيَّرَ حَالُ آخِرِهِ لَفْظًا أَوْ تَقْدِيرًا بِسَبَبِ الْعَوَامِلِ. It is anything that changes explicitly or implicitly due to the entering of an agent. Different agents are entering it, that's why it changes. وَالْمَبْنِيُّ, and mabni is مَا لَزِمَ آخِرُهُ حَالَةً وَاحِدًا, is when the word is consistent upon one situation. لِغَيْرِ عَامِلٍ وَلَا اَعْتِلَالٍ. The reason why it's in one situation is not due to a agent and it's not due to a defect. Okay, there's no defect here. Good. Does that make sense? The author asks you now to do an exercise. He says, بَيِّنِ الْمُعْرَبَ بِأَنْوَاعِهِ. Explain mu'rab and its types, with its types. وَالْمَبْنِيَّ, and explain mabni. مِنَ الْكَلِمَاتِ الْوَاقَعَةِ فِي الْعِبَارَاتِ الْآتِيَةِ, in the upcoming sentences. So inshallah ta'ala, everybody inshallah, if you don't have the book, try to find a person who has the book. Do this exercise. And now it starts from here. Every word you say, it's mu'rab or it's mabni. That's all you need to do. You don't have to go into too much details. You don't have to give a reason for it. Just identify it, okay? The poet, the sharih, he brought the line, he brought this paragraph, which is, قَالَ أَعْرَابِيٌ اللَّهُ يُخْلِفُ مَا أَتْلَفَ النَّاسُ وَالدَّهَرُ يُتْلِفُ مَا جَمَعُوا وَكَمْ مِنْ مَيِّتٍ عَلَّتُهَا طَلَبُ الْحَيَاةِ وَحَيَاةٍ سَبَبُهَا التَّعَرُّضُ لِلْمَوْتِ سَأَلَ عُمَرُ بْنُ الْخَطَّابِ عَمْرُ بْنُ مَعْدِي كَرَبٍ عَنِ الْحَرْبِ فَقَالَ لَهُ هِيَ مُرَّةُ الْمَذَاقِ إِذَا قَلَصَتْ عَنْ سَاقٍ مَنْ صَبَرَ فِيهَا عُرِفَ وَمَنْ ضَعُفَ عَنْهَا تَلِفَ وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى إن العلا حدثتني وهي صادقة فيما تحدث أن العز في النقل إذا نام غر في دجى الليل فاسهري وقم للمعالي والعوالي وشمري إذا أنت لم تقصر عن الجهل والخنا أصبت حليما أو أصابك جاهل الصبر على الحقوق المروءة الصبر على حقوق المروءة أشد من الصبر على ألم الحاجة وذلة الفقر مانعة من عز الصبر كما أن عز الغنى مانع من كرم الإنصاف. We'll try inshallah ta'ala every word, whether it's mu'rab or mabni, 5 to 10 minutes. 10 minutes inshallah ta'ala. Just identify each word. Is it mu'rab or is it mabni? Inshallah ta'ala. And he says to clarify if it's mu'rab, what type it is. Okay? And mabni. So just tell me if it's mu'rab, what type of mu'rab is it? Okay? And if it is, so we want, is it muqaddar or is it what? Lafzi. Okay? Explain that inshallah ta'ala for us. And if it's mabni, just say it's mabni. You don't need to say li ta'adhuri or istithqali or al munasaba. You don't need to do any of that.